drinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest, I got millions on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe.
Yellow V on my right leg, that's Gucci. Dig what I'm saying. Yellow V on my man, that's Gucci. Dig what I'm saying. Caught a little jet lag, but I'm golden. Yeah. We deserve Grammys and some Oscars. They deserve Whammies, they imposters. I be rolling with my project homies, it's a vibe. I just with the homie, it's a vibe. Over switch sides, it's a vibe. Yeah, yeah. I gon' do it, gon' do it, gon' do it. I gotta accept that I'm a. Yeah, yeah. I pull up in several different options, yeah, yeah, that I would most ever.
Welcome back to MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The Giants possessing the football. We rejoin the action in the second quarter. Second down to Vereen out in the flat. And Hill running right through it. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
The Giants on third down. 5 out of 9 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. From the gun, it's Manning. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and it'll be 4th down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. Well, not only did they try to fake it, they put the ball in the arm of their punter, and it didn't work out.
Not the quarterback.
No.
The punter.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
risky.
And it's so funny because when it works, genius. When it doesn't work, not so smart.
Not so genius.
In this case, not so genius, but I do admire that he went for it.
And a great spot to start this drive from here. Now again to the big fullback. This is Whitlock. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Credited with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position. And we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. Throwing on 3rd down, Stafford. And he's going to go out of bounds, taking it down inside the 25. It's a gain of 17, and it'll give him a 1st down.
And that's how you pick up a 1st down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Again, it's Abdullah. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one. Not surprising to see Collins in on the tackle. He had 125 of them last year, most by a safety in Giants history.
He plays like a linebacker in the run game. His biggest improvement last year, his ability to defend the pass. He's going to be one of the best safeties in the league for a long time.
Well run here, Abdullah. That he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
I like his focus there because he wasn't thinking about breaking that one big. All he thought about was, I need one. Let's go get that. Ended up picking up two.
Thank you. Stafford gives to Abdullah. And a pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Try the air now with Stafford. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Eric Ebron, his second touchdown on the season. And the Lions are in for six. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season. But don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. And his kick is right through. So that drive takes him down the field in eight plays. And it's capped off by a touchdown for the Lions. Here's Prater now set to kick it away. This one taken from the seven. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The New York set to take the field. First down, Manning. Over the middle to Beckham. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Well, that catch just gives us another reason to praise Odell Beckham Jr. Off to an incredible start to his NFL career.
Three Pro Bowls, three straight Pro Bowls, obviously, and first Giant to do that in more than 50 years, Charles.
And how about the numbers that he's put up also? 1,300 or more yards and 10 or more touchdowns in each of those three seasons.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. Second down, here's Manning. Throws left side, complete to Brandon Marshall. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down.
As explosive and dynamic a playmaker as Brandon Marshall's been in his career, can you believe he's never been to the postseason in 11 years?
Yeah, 11 years. He's hoping to get there, obviously, with the Giants. One thing's for sure, didn't have to move his locker far when he went from the Jets to the Giants, same facility.
You can keep the same address as well.
Manning now on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Akeem Spence continuing to fight downfield. The big tackle gets him for a loss of 11.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Manning to throw on second down. It's caught. Beckham. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
Now, this trio that New York has compiled, Brandon Marshall, Sterling Shepard, and, of course, Odell Beckham Jr., fits right into head coach Ben McAdoo's attack. They led the league in three wide receiver sets in 2016.
The Giants on third down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is third and 8. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We're back to East Rutherford, but first this timeout. A reminder with halftime approaching, when we get there, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Larry Ridley will have first half highlights and analysis.
And I hope he's iced down his throat because he's got a lot to get through because we've had no shortage of points scored in the first half.
It has been a fun track meet. The Giants on third down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This is third and 8. Working from the gun, Manning. He finds Beckham complete. That one goes for 24 yards.
Well, that's the kickstarter right there. Eli Manning finding his guy, Odell Beckham Jr.
Yeah, it's a deadly combination, isn't it?
It really is, but what really makes it work is just how unflappable Eli is with his demeanor, able to maintain his calm and his poise. Because we know, OBJ, he can run pretty hot and get excited out there.
Sometimes just one-handed grabs for him.
It doesn't matter what it is. Just throw it up there. He'll go get it.
The Giants offense, they were 30th in red zone trips a season ago, but they're in the red zone now, first and 10. Shotgun now for Manning. And it's caught. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
I'm pretty sure the Giants saw big success for Sterling Shepard coming out of Oklahoma. They could see him in their offense working in the middle of the field and making big catches.
Second only to Michael Thomas last year among rookies in receptions, yards, and touchdowns. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
Some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Third and long for the Giants and Eli following the sack. Operating from the gun, Manning. And Harris has got it. Touchdown, Giants. Dwayne Harris as the first half is winding down. And the Giants are in for six. Now whistles here. We're going to get a timeout taken by the offense as they'll use their second one of this first half and make sure they've got the play call right. Rosas to add the extra point. This is going to remain a two-point game after that one. And now a whistle and a timeout called by the kicking team as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. At the 30, but a shifty move got him a couple extra on the play. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. So second and medium, second and five now. A shotgun snap for Stafford. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. On first down, Stafford here. Over the middle, complete to Tate. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. The final shot before the break, Stafford. And he will be brought down as time has now run out on this first half of action. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we send you down to Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
So that's it for us. We'll go back now to East Rutherford for the start of the second half.
All right, LR, thank you, my man. Still anyone's contest, just a two-point game as we get set for the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is taken at the three. Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Here comes Matthew Stafford now to lead his offense back out there. And he's looking to take much better care of the football here in half two after three first-half interceptions.
We don't have to just look strictly at the numbers here. You know what else happens to a team when you turn it over three times like that? It erodes confidence in you. And it erodes confidence in the offense. And now you have the defensive guys looking over and saying, what is going on here? And instead of playing for the team, they're playing angry and mad at their teammates.
And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. Out of the gun, Stafford. To the right side, Eric.
Ladivia. Let's see if this is her, though.